The problem with using HF radio in a modern vehicle is that modern fuel injection and ignition systems can create a lot of interference. In a diesel engine, you don't have an ignition system, but the rest of it can still be pretty noisy. Some say that you just can't use HF in a modern vehicle, but we're going to show you how.
Now, just to ensure I can actually get back into the vehicle,
this connector back here is actually cable tied on because the locking tab got snapped off. Temporary fix, which has so far lasted about 15,000 kilometers in a year. Give you a tip that might save you $600. This part, if your Land Cruiser just gets slower and slower and you take it into the dealership and you're not quite sure what's wrong, and they're not quite sure what's wrong, they'll charge you $600 to take the whole thing apart and find out that this filter has a tiny hairline crack down it that lets the boost out, causing incorrect sensor readings, and the ECU goes into limp mode. I'll get up what the OBD2 code is on screen that you'll see flashing up if that's happening to you, but if you replace this part, which costs about $30, that is apparently really common. So unfortunately there's not enough slack to loop that through more than once. And always, always cable tie these things down, because those in a automotive environment, those clips don't always hold. What we're thinking of doing is we might get some wiring looms built up that extend it by about 30 centimeters, enough to run 3-4 turns through a ferrite if it's still an RF problem.
So that's the new connector. Verify that it fits before cutting the old one off.
So that stuff's 3-to-1 glue lined. That should be able to get over a solder joint. Should have brought the hacko up.
That bolt onto there goes in there.
Customary to stop before that point, and I'm surprised it's the bolt that went there. And you can't even tell the difference.
If you can't simultaneously slide it onto all of these things, pull them out, attach them to the part, then just push the part down into place.
So 80 meters, we're pretty much seeing S1 peaking to S3. 40 meters, mostly S0, just spiking to S3 to 5. 30 meters, yeah. Right, start the car. Talking about S7 at 80, what did we have before?
S4.
Okay, so somehow that one's worse.
40 is the one I'm keen for though. So before we had S6 and S.
We're at S6. Now we're down S3 peaking to S5. 30 meters, S5-ish.
S7. 20 was S9 here.
20 was flat S9, now we've got S5 to 7.
Well, I have things for those.
144 was pretty much S0.
Yeah, 0.
And 430, also S0. Boot up the stuff, still S0, but that has S5 out. So we got to trace out what causes that.
The front of the vehicle has now been completed with only the loss of one 10mm socket. Now it's time to do the back. So, ground this, and this. So, if that closes without displacing either of those, we should be good. Here, down to something down there.
that. So now I want to move that grounding braid from the Codan, preferably onto the chassis here, and then we'll go from here to here.
As this makes its way down the car, it's not really directly connected to the chassis in any way. It's typically mounted through rubber shock mounts for thermal and physical noise and vibration reasons. So what it in effect is it's bolted to the engine up that end, not connected to the chassis anywhere further down. It's almost like someone's put a big 4-meter aerial connected straight to the engine, which is the source of all of our radio noise. So it would be pretty important to ground this end of it to stop it from acting like a big aerial.
Full set of engineer's toothbrushes, hose clamps, and let's do this.
From there, to there, from there, to down here. So that one's on, and that one's on.
So just doing the band check with the car off, it seems annoyingly the ionosphere hasn't remained the same as yesterday, and there's now significantly better propagation on a number of the bands, resulting in quite a bit of noise that is just legitimately coming in from the environment. A success?
Yep.
Definitely. I'm hearing a lot of packets of 30.
Overall, that was a pretty big success, although there's a little bit more we can do for 30 and 20 meters. When we've done that, stay tuned for another video.